hop out. Ballet, walk out. All these bins I lost count. Cause I'm too up right now. Too up right now.
Pulling up in that new toy, the wrist on that boy, rock star like Pink Floyd. Waving that rude boy, I'm waving at you, boy. Ran off on the two like True Goy. Imagine me, dude, boy. You could never do what I do, boy. Still ducking that I did, boy. In Paris for a hit, boy. These ain't the same type of hits, boy. Can get. Boy, you don't take these type of risks, boy. Cause this boy been throwing that like rich, boy. You miss, boy. Your numbers don't add up on the. That was 10 years ago. If you know, you know. Yeah. If you know, you know. If you know, you know. This thing of ours, oh, this thing of ours. A fraternity of ringing off. I just happen to be alumni. Too legit, they still looking at me with one eye. The company I keep is not corporate enough. Shout.
And coach, we find ourselves due east from our nation's capital at FedEx Field in Landover, Maryland. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Indianapolis Colts and the Washington Redskins. Two teams here, each off to 1-0 starts as this one is underway on EA Sports. This will be taken in at the 1. And spins away. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. And on the ground they go with a running back. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable 2nd down. A very solid gain on that play.
Side of midfield before going out of bounds. A good pick up there, 26 yards. And early on, they're picking up right where they left off last week.
And I know a lot of coaches say each game is its own. You don't really have carryover. This feels like carryover. So much confidence from the previous game that they're using to their advantage now.
In Washington territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 46. They'll run with a former Badger. It's Corey Clement. And a pretty big hole as he's down to about the 40. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Throw on 2nd down. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he gets it down to the 32. His 1st catch, good for 9 and a 1st down.
When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback, a hot route, so to speak.
Blue 58!
Now a play fake here on first down, and this will be incomplete.
That one didn't quite make it to the target, but that's not always a function of the strength of the arm of the quarterback, is it? Sometimes there's just too much pressure there. In any case, the ball doesn't arrive.
Here's second and 10 now from about the 32. Rodgers will try again on second down. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. Touchdown, Indianapolis. A great play there. His second touchdown on the season. And the Colts are going to take a first quarter lead. Extra point splits the uprights. And that makes the score 7-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. A first carry for Leonard Fournette. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Bradley Roby, the quarterback, there to make the stop. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead them to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity, and that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week. And right now, we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up a touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now, or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
Back to the air on second down. Wentz, nowhere to go here. He lost the football. But the Redskins look to get this one back, and indeed they did. It's still Washington football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is a quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction down.
But when this ball's tipped and intercepted, picked off at the 47. Look at the spin.
Balance.
And a super return as he gets us all the way down inside the 25-yard line.
Well, they didn't exactly show patience there, did they? Just down a score, they come out firing right away and compound things by throwing an interception. They put their defense in a really tough spot.
And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the pickup, and they're going to face a third down.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
In danger of squandering their great field position as they come up on a 3rd and 7. Working from the gun, Rodgers, and he'll have his man. That's Cooper. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Cooper's first catch, and good for a first down.
someone's sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass on the first drive, he comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Two touchdown passes now here in this first quarter for Aaron Rodgers. And the Colts add on to their lead. Point after, right down the middle. And that'll make the score 14-0. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll probably wish he'd reconsidered here. It will cost him 10 yards as he's down at the 15.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light there. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Throw left side, complete to Ingram. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
And he'll get this up to about the 40. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Well, you're down early. How do you get back in the game, maybe establish the run? I think they're trying to do that.
Now, I'm with you on that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offensive coordinator, let's run the football. Let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game.
7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
More Tokyo!
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. Eddie Jackson with a tackle.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
Now they'll throw it. Wentz steps away to his left. He'll end up getting 5 out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir, able to turn that into a positive game.
And Ingram holds it in and brought down, but the juke, the very nice juke, gives him the first down yardage there. That one good for 7 as this long drive continues and the chains move again. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. It's a loss of a yard there, and now 2nd down. Now that play was doomed right from the start.
He just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
Now Fournette. 4 yards on the pickup there as they get it back to a more manageable 3rd and 7.
On a 2nd and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on 3rd down.
Throwing his Wentz. He's going to loft one deep left side here, and that will fall incomplete. Oh, they took a shot there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. And the first play will be a field goal try. This from 54 yards away. And his kick is good. Oh, he just did tuck it into the bottom of that left corner. And they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3.
These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right? Baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
Now the Colts offense gets ready to head back on the field.
And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stopped that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
Now a play fake. Rodgers. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup, and it'll be third down.
But it's tough to be a defender in today's NFL because there's so many things to account for in today's passing game, including the back sneaking out of the backfield. Not quite as bad as a turkey bowl where you have that center eligible stuff, but still a lot of guys to account for.
From the gun on third down, Rodgers. Throw left side, taken in by Hill. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. His first catch, good for 8 and a first down.
But give the defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat them on that play, did they?
No, the drag, that guy can be your safety valve. We saw it right there.
Yeah, and they picked up the first down for him, too.
And they'll run it here. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
Playing against a 3-4 front is really challenging for offensive linemen because they can do so many different things. But when you're running the football, if you can handle the nose tackle up front and then maybe a guard can slide up to the second level and block a linebacker, that's when you have success running the football.
Over the middle, complete. It's short. And now off to the races, down the right side. Touchdown, Indianapolis. A big play. His first touchdown of the new season. And the Colts are able to grow their lead. Extra point forthcoming. Extra point right down the middle. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see.
On 2nd down, here's Wentz. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. But the Redskins look to get this one back, and indeed they did. It's still Washington football. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but if the other team doesn't get it, that's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
Solomon Thomas with a big-time sack on 3rd down, and it'll be a loss of 7. And he was called on 3 times in the win last week as his first one here's away. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And the ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it could be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
Go, go, go.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down here at about the 23-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. Umpire threw the flag, usually always indicates holding, and that's what we've got.
And you know, depending on their positioning, where you are on the field, the umpires get different responsibilities, but always, always making sure no one's holding.
Now Rodgers throwing on second down. Now look out, Rodgers lost the football, and the Redskins scoop it, and they've got the football, and they're already knocking on the door inside the five at the 4-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But, hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not going to tip it. I'm going to doff my...
And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington. A great effort there. His second touchdown on the season. And the Redskins are able to cut into that deficit. Extra point up and good by Succop, and it makes the score 21-10. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. The Colts offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
You know, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. The tackle was by the Boston College product, Harold Landry. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack. And on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
To throw on second down, Rodgers. Throwing for his running back, and he's got it complete. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. Give him six on the play, and that'll lead here to a third down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Now it's Rodgers, and that is incomplete.
And I feel like my man, Old Mo, momentum might be changing jerseys right now. How about what they just got done? They scored a touchdown their last drive. Now here's a three and out. Maybe momentum's getting ready to creep to the other sideline.
The Colts send out their punter, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. A look at Washington as they come onto the field.
I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? We'll see what they decide to do.
On first and 10, here's Wentz. He's letting this one go for Fuller. And that is caught one-handed. Oh, my, he pulled it in. And all the way down to the 22-yard line.
Tell the truth, partner. You didn't think he was coming down with that one, did you? Come on, tell me the truth.
No, I didn't. I'll tell you what, though. A one-handed grab of that length, Talk about giving your team a little juice.
Oh, big time. I mean, everyone's going to be excited about that one, whether you're on the field or not.
And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. A great play there. His second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Redskins are able to make this a close game again. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, two already. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. Back to FedEx Field following this short break. Now a handoff looking right. And he'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
The passing game's been working quite well so far, but the running game's been a little bit of a struggle. And that's a surprise to me. Typically, when you can throw it, you've opened up lanes for your runners.
To throw is Rodgers. Looking to throw on second down. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. If you combine last week and this week, he's got a hat trick going because he had 2 interceptions a week ago.
He's seeing the ball so well and understanding where receivers are and positioning. I mean, just watching him work with such great technique and paying it off by actually catching the ball when he has a chance, he's helping his team in a huge way.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. 4-6 defense, they were daring him to run the football. They ran it. A little football 101. Take us through what the 4-6 defense is, Charles.
So what you're trying to do with your big defensive front is cover the interior offensive lineman, the center, and the two guards, and make it difficult if you even want to think about running the ball inside. If you can control them, that allows the linebackers and the safeties to run free and get to the ball carriers. And that play worked really well. No gain.
The Redskins on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is third and 4. Shotgun now for Wentz. Escaping the pressure right. He can run for it, and he will. Wentz can pull it down when he needs to, and the 6'5 quarterback picks up the first down.
We just saw a nice example of why teams often bring in baseball guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy. Make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 19. And they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
So after the INT, it's Rodgers. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. A gain of 6 there on first.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. Rodgers now at 200 yards already in this first half, and he's not done yet. First and 10. They fake the give. Now Rodgers. And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down. They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10.
Hey, check 26.
Rodgers again here on second and 10. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. The Colts on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. And again, it's Rodgers. Wide open receiver complete. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. On the left hash, officially it's called a 51-yard attempt. And this one is right down the middle. So we come to halftime here with the visiting Colts taking the lead. Due to time constraints, we move you forward in today's broadcast to the beginning of the third quarter. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. It'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. So out now come the Redskins. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the...
And he'll be brought down by the Colts.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. Now a play fake. Wentz. He's letting it fly for Cooks. And that one was nearly picked. Not sure he was accounting for the free safety. That brings up third down.
Credit the secondary and credit the defensive game plan. They've been in his hip pocket all game long. They understood coming in that he was a big-time receiver.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. They'll run it now out of the gun. Fournette fighting through. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. It's a 7-yard run, but it does bring up fourth down. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, it makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
Fielded at about the 28. A great return there of 22 yards. And this offense will take over right at the midfield stripe with a first and 10. Here's the Colts now as they get ready for their first possession on offense of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away.
We got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
The false start backs them up 5. First and 15.
Jump out. Look at the end.
From the gun, it's Rodgers. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
16 yards the pickup there. The Colts have a first down.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. When you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tough for guys trying to get to the football.
Folded like a lawn chair. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down. The Colts on third down, they've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This is third and 7.
319!
Play action. Now it's Rodgers. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked.
Love the effort there. I mean, to get a field goal block in this situation because they knew what was going on. They give up those 3 points there. It's now a two-possession game.
Yeah, that really changes the complexion here in the second half, doesn't it?
It really does, and now you give your team more than a fighting chance and a little momentum. Terrific job by them setting the tone and picking up their defense.
And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
The Colts are going to get him. Down he goes. Joey Bosa. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. After the sack, it's 2nd and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Now wins. And he's going to go down again.
I think normally we would talk about this more with basketball players and football players, but let's adopt it in this case. He's a stat sheet stuffer.
Had the interception earlier, now a sack. What, he just needs a touchdown for the trifecta.
That's about all he needs, and he's going to go for it.
Needs something from deep in the bag of tricks here after 1st and 2nd down went backwards. It's 3rd and very long. Wentz now to throw. They still can't get it. He's letting it fly for Cook. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Eddie Jackson picks it. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line.
I think that interception happened for 2 reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket and panics a little bit. And the receiver doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. There's a guy lurking, took the ball for him.
So don't wave your arms, right, as a receiver if you're not wide open?
Got to know that you're open. Otherwise, just don't do it.
The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on 2nd down.
Rodgers to throw on 2nd down. Going up top. And that is caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis. 4 touchdown passes now for Aaron Rodgers. And thanks to the interception, the Colts offense cashes in with 6. Extra point splits the uprights, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And here come the Redskins now. Yardage on the play, back at his own 19-yard line. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up 2nd down.
Well, if these guys are going to chop into that deficit, they're going to have to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage would be found.
Well, the first play of the drive, lost 4. Now they'll look to move it forward here on 2nd and 14. Open man right side is Ingram, and he'll get it up here this time to the 21. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up 3rd down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
He
he's letting this one go for Fuller. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by the corner, Bradley Roby. And a great return as he gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line. Just a little bit of a rough stretch. Six interceptions now in these last 2 weeks combined.
I know the easy thing is to go back to mechanics, footwork, things of that nature. I'm also wondering, is he getting fooled by what he's seeing on defense? Has the scouting report changed? Are they showing him things different than what he expected? For the second week in a row, he's throwing it to the guys in the wrong color shirts.
Yeah, he better figure, whatever the reason is, he better figure it out.
Looking to throw on second down. Rodgers. Looking for Cooper, and it's intercepted. Reuben Foster picks it, and his guys will take over at the 25-yard line. Intended that time for Cooper. He's on quite the interception run. He had two last week, another one here. Remember, he's not a DB, he's a linebacker.
But how many of those linebackers started as DBs and pumped themselves up into being linebackers? So the ball skills are the same, right? The coverage skills and responsibilities are the same, and he is paying it off in a big, big way. I don't think any of us were surprised that they decided to start this drive on the ground after the last two drives ended in interceptions.
Unfortunately, though, not a lot going on that first play.
Yeah, I think the anticipation was felt also by the defense.
And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
This is four now. He'll get about three as he's brought down right around the 42.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Shorty.
They fake the give. Now Wentz steps away. And he's going to lose yardage here. As they will switch ends as time has run out on this third quarter of play. Back now at FedEx Field. It's the Redskins with the football, but trailing here as we get down to the good stuff. Quarter number four. The Redskins on third down. They've struggled to the tune of 2 for 8 so far. This is third down and 12. Working from the gun, Wentz. And this is going to be incomplete. Getting a hand in there and knocking it away, Eddie Jackson.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. Now here's Michael Dixon as he's on to punt for Washington. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over. Up to the 22.
But Brandon, pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythema Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line. And it's Reuben Foster in on the tackle.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
The Colts on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5.
Green 18. Hey, check 26.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. He is going to find Hill here. He got 29 yards that time. They have the nice cushion. They just want to pour it on right now, still throwing the football.
And I know my background says, why do you need to do this? Just go ahead and run out the clock and get a win. But as many people pointed out to me, it's a video game, man. Go ahead and put the numbers up. Sportsmanship, not an issue.
Exercise those fingers. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. To throw on 2nd down. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. 23 yards on the play.
Jumbo!
On 1st down, Rodgers. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Well, those two have hooked up for a touchdown once already in this game, that time unable to find the completion.
Yeah, it just appeared they wanted to get him out into open space and try and get him the football. As you mentioned, unable to connect.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him 4 on the ground there. They're now left with 3rd and 6.
They're in a pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves, start to try and pound them into submission.
And the offensive line, they've controlled this game. I don't see why that trend would change now.
A 1st carry for Samaje Perine. And he's brought down. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
Starting to feel a little to me like the air is coming out of the balloon, so to speak, defensively.
They're taking their will from them right now. That's what they're doing. Whatever they want to call, it's working. They're handling things up front. And it's not just the offensive line. It's everyone. You're seeing the guys on the perimeter blocking downfield and making sure that they're secure.
So, yeah. And he takes it in for a Colts score. Aaron Rodgers taking it in. And the Colts add on to their lead. And they wasted no time right down near the goal line, and they just sneak it in.
Just do what you need to do. Big guys going up front. Have the field general, the leader, just fall in behind them.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's going to wind up bringing this one inside the 45-yard line.
Even after that big-time return, it's not looking great for them today. But if nothing else, even if the miracle doesn't happen, they can turn to this play and say, hey, we can move forward. Maybe it's a building block for the rest of the season.
Wentz now on 1st down. And this is caught. I think he got that with one hand. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. Brandon Cooks, his 1st touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Redskins are able to close the gap just a bit. To throw, it's Wentz. And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, If you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed, near the goal line, on a two-point conversion, all that extra, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And the decision to come out is going to cost him five as he's taken down right at the 20. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
And he will lose yardage on the play, back at his own 19-yard line. And now we're going to get a timeout called by the Redskin defense. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. On second down, here's Rodgers. And he's got Cooper on the out route. That's complete. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. 16 yards the pick up there. The Colts have a first down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now they try the right side here. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
319 to 9.
Go ground game here with a tailback, and he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. And this defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the 2-minute warning. And they'll go with a ground attack here, and he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first. And now here comes the third of their timeouts defensively.
Let's go, come on.
So they'll be left with only the 2-minute warning to stop it from here on out.
319!
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, first and 10. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. Again, here's P-Ryan, and he'll be taken down at the 34. It'll only be a gain of a yard, and it sets up a third down and 4 now.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
The Colts on third down. They've hit on 6 of their 8 tries. Very good. This is third and 4.
319.
And on the ground they go with the running back. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
Hasn't been his best afternoon on the ground, far from it, but a critical third down conversion.
His afternoon just got better. All right, you're exactly right. It hasn't been his best in terms of yardage, but that run there, that's the one your teammates look to you and go, okay, that's what we want from you, that's what we need. Now they have a chance to keep moving forward and a chance to win the game.
The Colts in victory formation now as they take the knee. Rodgers will take a knee here, and that should be all she wrote. Well, I know at points in this when you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points.
Settings. If you wish to change roles or adjust options, use the tiles on the right.
Don't I look like somebody that just be bodying and everything? All that talking is great, but I don't be talking. I air it out. All the problems have gotten easy to bury. I'd rather kiss on my. I've been broke away longer than I've been rich, so until it levels out, I'ma take mama to the Marriott. Took me so long to get it, gonna spread it out. Let them know all about me when I'm dead and gone.
One in the hand, one in the bag, bubba. One in the hand, one in the bag, bubba. Look at the cash, look at the cash, bubba. Look at the cash, bubba. One in the hand, one in the hand, one in the hand, one in the bag, bubba. Look at the cash, look at the cash, bubba. Look at the cash,
I'm gonna need all the fries you can give me, all the hot sauce, all the pie you can give me. Better be all or nothing, don't have me in the middle. You better be all you can, yeah, 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 yeah.
Super fly for the Dumbos, plenty slides like a shuffle. Hit the cadence on my young girl, Isaac Hayes, Billy Ocean. About the old O with the cane stick, let my slippers at the function. It's hard to run the Gucci slides, that bet you say you didn't ever. I'ma stand up. Chain, no travel, can't clean it with the beans, dripping from the, no, no, not me, I can never be the one you want to stuff for, money, money, that machine, the bell got my stove, RIP the times that I was broke, acting like a 9-11 folks, matte black, liquor clean, dead places in and I'm a local, cooking up canard, waiting for the antidote, running out of time, patience thinner than a penny, ho,
don't empty your pockets, I don't do that.
One in the hand, one in the bag, bubba.
Select the team you want to join.
Look at the cash, look at the cash, bubba. Look at the cash, bubba. One in the hand, one in the hand, one in the hand, one in the hand, one in the bag, bubba. Look at the cash, look at the cash. Bubbling. Look at the cash, bubbling.
Money back.